Greetings, my name is Jay, and welcome to my Albert Odyssey Legend of Eldean Let's Play for the Sega Saturn. This is episode 2, and in this episode we're going to be starting our main adventure. Just as an interesting point, because I found this kind of peculiar, in Albert Odyssey I was only saving on the memory card, as you saw in the last part of the last episode. And what ended up actually happening whenever we reloaded it and tried to start up episode 2 was that after pressing the start button, it went right into the story mode. It looks like it reads off the internal system memory on whether or not you have a save file to resume from. So I thought that was kind of interesting. So I moved the file over to the internal RAM, and yeah, I guess I'll just work off of the internal RAM while I'm playing the game. Although it will, if you go back, it will let me just make multiple saves, up to 5, for that, but I'll just work off the internal memory. Anyway, I thought that was interesting. Okay, so to recap, in the last episode, our half-sister, Laia, has been turned to stone, granite of all things, which I guess is a rough granite, poorly granite. And Folte, your half-brother, it has to stay around and protect the city, but the only magic that can cure Laia is to use human magic. And I'm going on an adventure to try and figure out how to solve turning her back from stone to the actual flesh, and that's our current adventure and quest. So I didn't talk to these guys. And they're just telling me that they're all praying for me and for Laia. Okay, so let's see. Dear Best Pike, we're all praying for you and for Laia. I guess I no longer need to go out with a person or somebody else. Okay, so that's interesting. I guess that mark is the town. Can I go back to it? Yes, I can. Okay. Okay, so I'm not exactly certain where it is that the game wants me to go, so we're going to have to do some exploring. Let's look at the actual map, and I'm going to head, I don't know, north, I guess? Yeah, we want to save, and okay. So, yeah, let's head along the coastline and see what happens. I think there's random battles. I actually really like the, animation for, forests or edges, and I'm assuming I can't go onto the beach. Oh, battle! Oh, load times are actually not that bad. Haha, Pike's so cute! Okay, so, let's see. We have our attack, defend. This is very similar to Shining Force, actually. So let's just attack this weredog. Alright. Oh, okay, doesn't have that many hit points. Huzzah! Pike's party won the battle. 2 experience gained. 1 gold. And that's everything. Let's actually check and see how many experience points Pike needs to level up. So if I go to status, it says I have 5 experience points. And I think that used to say 7, so I must need 5 experience points to level. I think it's a countdown. Only based off observation. I guess after a couple battles we will find out. Alright, let's continue exploring along the coastline. Looks like we've got a river up here. I wonder if we can walk across that. Oh, another battle! Oh, another weredog. It shouldn't pose much of a problem unless he can go first. So we have, let's see, this is magic. This is run, items, and defend. So we're just going to attack because that seemed to work last time. Oh, he defended. I guess that's what that ting is. There we go. 15, that's one less than last time. He's still gonna die? Yeah, he must have like 10 hit points or maybe 15. We gain 2 experience points, 1 gold. Alright, so let's double check our counter just so we understand how the experience works in this game. Status. Oh, okay, it's right there on this screen. So 3, I had 5 last time. So yeah, it's a countdown. Alright, that's cool. Okay, so I can't actually walk across that, and there's no thing on the edge, so let's go this way. And I'm not really one to just run away from random battles. I might edit some of them out so that they're not too repetitive. But the main reason why is because it usually prevents you from grinding these types of games. Although in the translation notes of the manual, they actually did mention that they changed some of the stats of the monsters and stuff like that, and amount of experience points that you needed so you didn't have to grind as much, because they found that that would probably be not as fun. But they did make a mention that in the manual and these linear notes, basically, that... okay, I was wondering why that guy wasn't dying. They did make a mention that the ratio-wise, everything still works out pretty much the same. It's just you can essentially, you don't have to grind as much. Anything in here? Nope. It's a little hard to tell whether or not I considering a harpy forest was that little blob on the map. The brown section on the map. Ooh, the background change is pretty cool. I like the sky, too. That's kind of neat. It's got neat parallax scrolling going on here with the background and giving it semi-3D effect. It's totally not 3D, but it definitely works for perspective-wise. So 16, he should be dead. So we have the Harpy Forest. So yeah, the main reason why I'm going north is because on the map, in the manual on page 2-3, there's a town to the south called Mycent, and there's a town to the north called Chestora, and I'm gonna try and make it to Chestora. Oh, sweet, we leveled up. What happens? We learn the spell Lecture, and that's it. We probably gain some hit points and stuff like that as well, so let's check out what Lecture does. Lecture, I think this will actually tell me, so if we go to Magic, it causes sleep. Cool. So against more powerful enemies, that's probably... probably a really good spell to use. Okay, so... Oh, here's a town here. Alright, so it's not as... It's kind of like Lunar, I guess. It's not as hard to tell where a section is as I thought it might be. That Harpy Forest, walking into it, seemed to be... Oh, is this where we came from? Oh, that's not... Well, I guess... Would he know? Huh. I wonder if he knows this is where he's from. Is the sword gonna tell him? Who is this? Strange man. Why, hello, young man. Such a nice surprise to see someone here in this desolate and depressing place. But I find it quite unusual that you would be here at all. If you don't mind my asking, young man, what is your given name, boy? I don't know you, so let's give him the silent treatment. Please do not fear me, boy. I am only made curious by this chance encounter of ours. Besides, you are armed and armored. I have only my old and gnarled hands to defend myself. You could be a monk, I don't know. What strange calling has brought you to this monument to pain and suffering? This is no place for children to scurry about, certainly. Although, I'll have you know that the game called me a young man at 10 years old, so take that, old man. Oh, maybe he does know that this is home. I'm cruising for chicks. Okay, I'm just gonna tell him that this was my home. Ooh, it shocked him. What? You were born here? Judging from the state of this rubble, this place has been forsaken for 10 years or more. If this is true, if this truly was your home, I weep for your pain, young one. I truly do. But enough time wasted longing for things of time past. I must resume my search. Take care, my young friend. Perhaps we shall meet again. What is he searching for? I sense its presence. It was here. It was most certainly here when the goblins destroyed this place so many years ago. I should have come here back then when I felt its presence. Were I not so foolish, all this would have been prevented. All this destruction, this waste, but my arrival was too late. 10 years too late, but dude. And now, the presence grows strong once more. Much stronger than before. My heart swells, my pulse quickens, my mouth grows so very dry. After all this time in searching, it's finally within my grasp. What? Are you looking for Cirrus? But please, excuse my selfish indulgence. I really must depart at once. I have but one thing to ask of you, young one. If you find anything unusual, hold it close. I will find you. That's a little weird. Okay. Oh, there's a pot over there. Maybe there's something in it. Can I get over there? Yeah. Peer into the pot. A mint! Somehow that mint survived 10 years and the fire. That makes total sense. I'll take it. Is there anything in this pot? Nope. Oh, maybe there's something in that one. I can't get in there. I'll have to get in from a different angle, perhaps? Oh, I know what I should do. So, judging by... Maybe one of these homes are Pike's house, and he knows that it's his house because they told him it was? I don't know. That's probably escaping off the map. No, I guess that's not going to create an event. See, I can go past the tree line. Why didn't they go through the fence? Oh, well. Well, that was definitely something. And I'm curious, can I save it on the world map? Load saved game. Nope, I cannot. So I guess I have to actually make it over to one of those save crystals. Interesting. Alright, let's continue on our way. Another battle. Oh, another weredog. It's pretty good, easy experience if I do say so myself. Generally 1.5 hits, I would say, if I can hit him once. Oh, I hit him for 21. That's 5 more damage than normal. So that level up actually did pretty good. So gain 2 experience, 1 gold obtained. How much experience do I need to gain the next level? Let's just double check. 13. Okay, so it's almost double. Alright. Oh, there's a bridge. Let's go towards that. Just make sure that there's nothing over here. Oh, something's happening. Who's this? Oh, more weredogs. You need help? Pretty girl, what? Your timing could not be better, Swordsmaster. So, those drooling monsters over there, they have set their sights on my innards and nice Chianti. But I know that your sword is deft enough to slice their plan to ribbons, Swordmaster. Okay, so you want me to save you, basically. So I was thinking you could fight them while I turn around and run very fast. Sounds like a plan? Great. Thank you so much, you big, strong hunk of a manhood. Oh, by the way, good luck. Okay, you're welcome? Oh, 2 weredogs. Alright, so let's slice this guy up. Damn, missed. Oh. Ah, sweet. My defense is too good for these guys. Got him. next one should be fairly easy to take out. I like how the battle map is matching the actual terrain. That's really cool. Alright, cool. Gain 4 experience and 2 gold. Did the girl... Oh, you're still here. Oh, that was so smooth, Swordmaster. I wanted to run, but your skill with the blade transfixed me. I had to watch. Are you some kind of sicko? I'll just say my pleasure, miss. No, really, I simply cannot thank you enough. I was most certainly roast meat on a dirty spit until you arrived, Swordmaster. Oh, by the way, I'm Lulu. Well, Lulu's Salibin. Salibin. Okay, Lulu Salibin, actually, but everyone calls me Lulu. I've noticed that you've been looking at my unusually well-developed eyebrows. I what? I'll spare you the trouble of asking the obvious question. Yes, I am the offspring of a human and a beast. Oh, okay. And no, I do not like sniffing other beasts' butts as a rule, Swordmaster. I was teased so much as a child that I developed a sense of biting humor as a defense. My turn-ons include foot rubs and shiny swords, and I'm dedicated to better living through herbal medicine. Phew. End of awkward introduction phase. I hate that part of meeting new people, don't you know? Well, it feels like I've known you forever, I guess, since you're giving me so much information I haven't asked for. Anyway, as you just witnessed, traveling isn't easy, or safe for that matter, as I wish it was. But it's worth the risk to make people healthy and happy. There can't be enough happiness in the world, you know? So, how about you check out what I have for sale? I bet you could find something to make you feel better. Sounds like a plan? Great. Then whip out your money pouch and show me the money. There's no double entendre there at all.
Let's get down to business, Swordmaster.
That's pretty cool. I like how there's the little voice actions in the game. This would have blown my mind in 1996. So we can get mints. Spearmints? What do they do? I'm assuming they're... Actually, I have the manual right here. A spearmint restores more hit points. Doesn't say how much. Peppermint does even more, to the maximum. Calm Herbs Pink Rogue is... where is that? Not listed. Interesting. And sunglasses. So let's buy one of these. And one of these. Oh, it says up at the top, it just doesn't, nice makeup, and don't know what the sunglasses are. Okay, maybe they're quest items, who knows? So I got one of each. And, yeah, well, let's call that a day. Can I sell stuff? There's nothing I really want to sell.
Be careful out there, Swordmaster.
I will be careful. Thanks for your patronage, Swordmaster. My name is Pike, by the way. Just for future reference, though, there are no full-price returns. It's a health issue, really. I can buy them back, but I'll have to charge 50% restocking fee to cover sterilization and refurbishing costs. Anyway, that's about it. I'd better be on my way. Did you have any questions before I depart, Swordmaster? Do you know of a powerful priest in this area? You are extremely weird, but I think I love you. I'm gonna ask her, if, they've heard of a priest. No. Okay. Afraid not. However, you might want to ask around in the town of Gilgarl, north of here. It's a quaint little burg with nice folk. They can probably help you out, Swordmaster. Well, I've certainly overstayed my welcome, Swordmaster. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for saving me. I shall remember your good deed always. Besides, who knows, perhaps our paths will cross again. Stranger things have happened. See ya! But Gilgarald actually isn't on this map. I guess this map only has the... And I'm talking about the map and the instruction manual. Must have only the main cities. And I think Lulu, if I recall... Yeah, she is one of the characters in the cast of characters in the manual. And it says, half-human, half-beast, this sharp businesswoman is quickly taken by Pike's moves in battle. Never far when there's profit to turn on a sale. Lulu lives to serve Pike's every need. Oh, she does she? Okay. So I'm guessing she's going to be one of the party members in the game later. Is there anything else up here? Doesn't look like it. Alright, that most likely brings us to the other side of the bridge, and we're looking for Gilnard? Let's continue on. Maybe... Oh, there's some sort of thing blocking our way. There is a forest patch in that... green patch in that... oh, new monsters! So I'm gonna check out that corner, basically, of the forest. Because it looks like there's a green patch there. And I'm thinking it might be the town she mentioned. Okay, I wonder if this works against all enemies. Oh, it does. I love how Lecture puts people to sleep. that's gotta be a working designs thing. I didn't see any icons show up saying they're sleeping, so I'm gonna try and kill this guy first. Probably a little bit weaker, and it will prevent an extra attack per round, so... Okay, good. I'm like, wait for it, please die. Oh, sweet, okay. Oh, I guess they're asleep, because I thought an icon would show up above them. Well, that spell definitely made this a heck of a lot easier. Wow, and this guy has a lot of hit points. So I'll have to watch out for those slimes. How much experience did that give us? 14. Holy cow. Did we level? Yeah. Sweet. So let's check out our status. And so we have 25 attack. Hit is kind of like a percentage of hitting. Defense is obviously your armor. Wisdom has something to do with your MP. And agility helps run and stuff. Resist is resist against magic. Okay, so cool. We need 22 experience to get to the next level. So, is this actually a thing? Come on, load map. No, it's not. Okay. Let's go, I guess, up to here. Maybe this is the town? No, it's just blocked. I guess it's keeping me in line so I don't go off to different areas. What are these, like, were-rats? Bad rats. Close enough. They have a pretty good defense. Although, I guess my defense is a lot better. Oh, shit. Come on, Pike. Okay, so they must have 35-ish hit points. I'm not sure if I should write this information down. I could just look it up, but I'm not going to. I kind of want to keep this as fresh as possible. Okay, so I'm going to try and kill him, and then I'll definitely use a mint after battle. Okay, good, he died. How much experience did they give me? Let's see. 13, okay. 7.5 each. Or 6.5 each. Okay, so let's go to items. Maybe I should have bought more mints. Okay, so let's use this. Okay, back to full. Awesome. And I can't save, eh? Load saved game. Yeah, okay. All right, let's continue on our quest for this new city. It's over here. Doesn't look like I can go up there. Is this probably blocked? Yep, it's blocked. Random encounter rate's not actually too bad. So we got two more goblins. I guess getting all of these battles out of the way now will be pretty good. Even if I am a little tiny lost. Oh, whoa, okay, so that's actually a... See, this is... They're not using very good identifiers as to where the town is. So I just went over to the east coast and south towards the river where we were in the last video, killed a whole bunch of stuff, gained some experience points, and yeah, so apparently I should have just gone... over to here. Wait till this loads. To that little tiny bridge there, and that's actually or dock, I guess, and that's actually a place where you can go. Mountain pass entrance. All right. Sirius, there's a letter inside a bottle. She reads the letter aloud. She's hooked on phonics. Oh, wow, I remember hooked on phonics. I totally need help. These two, like, way harsh goblins were holding me prisoner. And I'm all let me go, and they're all no way, so save me, okay? Okay. Guess we got Valley Girl living in this part of the Albert Odyssey world. Nether bottle. I totally need help. Okay, this is the same thing. I guess let's go into this cave. Mountain pass. Oh, that's a pretty cool effect. Can I go across this water? No, I cannot. Uh-oh. What's gonna be in here, goblins? Ooh, some sort of snake and weredog. So I know I can kill a weredog in one hit, so I'm actually going to take it out first. don't... Hopefully, the snake can probably poison me, actually. I should watch out. So it's called a pit viper. I have a pretty good defense, actually. Oh, wow. Come on. There we go. Do they have good hit points? Oh, no, they don't. Actually, what does that thumbs up mean? It means... Character's resistance to magic will be increased. Okay, so, Pike's has a good resistance to magic, I guess. Okay, so there are random battles in here. Okay, let's walk across this. Go that way, I guess. Definitely want to explore all of the map has to offer, just in case there's little secrets. Got more pit vipers. Alright, so maybe I want to put them to sleep? They don't seem to be poisoning me, but let's put them to sleep. Let's lecture them. Give them a good lesson in algebra or something. Yeah, so that's a little annoying, because I can't tell whether or not one of them's sleeping or the other one is not. Maybe they just automatically all go to sleep. Oh, and that actually probably decreases defense, too, so that would make them a lot easier to kill. But I don't have very much MP. Okay, that's a pretty good strategy against those if I come into a lot of them. They're worth pretty good experience points, that's for sure. What are we, almost to the next level? Yeah, we have 3 experience points until we hit level 5. That's pretty sweet. Okay, I can't actually go that way. So let's follow up here. Keep going. Okay, so I'm not sure if, let's use sleep on them, or lecture, to make them fall asleep. It might be in the color that, they highlight in? I'm not sure. So that one's obviously because I hit him. I was thinking about these old games, especially in the mid-90s, it was kind of the transition period between when status elements and stuff like that... Oh! And different things weren't necessarily always shown on the screen for you. So, like Final Fantasy 1, for example, telling which ones fell asleep and which ones couldn't, or which ones didn't fall asleep, next to impossible, you basically had to guess and hope that you weren't attacking the wrong ones. Huzzah! Level 5. Refresh spell learned. Refresh. I think that's hit points. So let's go up to our menu. Let's see. So, Pike, refresh, heal conditions. 3 MP. Okay. Just reading that from the manual. Alright. So let's go to magic. And, alright. Oh, we have 21 MP in total. We don't have any items to actually, heal MP, so that's too bad. Alright, well, let's continue on. Wow, okay, that was really fast. Maybe it's a time thing instead of a steps thing? Alright, let's take the weredog first. Get him out of the way. Aw, come on, Pike. You had one job. One job! Well, at least nobody hit you, so we're back to round one, effectively. Alright. Oh, it got 2 attacks? That's a little unfair. Wow, 42 damage. Just dealing out the damage with Pike. Alright, so Pit Viper, you're going down. Maybe tomorrow. Okay, so let's actually continue on. Dum-de-dum. Oh, what's this? There's magic in the water, I can feel it. But I don't know if the magic is good or bad. Drink the water or spit in the water? Let's drink it. That sounded bad. Oh, okay. Restored your HP and MP. Awesome. Thank you, water. Good thing I didn't spit in it. Probably would have killed me.
Thank you.
Oh, okay, we found a door. What is in this door? Oh, it's those guys who killed their parents. And a fairy. Like, at last. Oh, it's the Valley Girl. My hero has come to totally rescue me from the most heinous beasts. These goblins are dangerous, Pike. Fight the smart fight. Okay. So we're taking on goblins that our father could not. Though I suppose there was more than just two of them. And I'm going to start off by lecturing them to death. You killed my parents! Screw you! Hopefully this works. Okay, it worked against the bottom one. I'm going to attack that bottom one first because he is dazed and won't be able to defend himself. That seems to be the way that the game works. 39 damage. Okay, kills him, so he's got like probably 35 health. Alright, let's just try and attack and see if he's got pretty good defense. Nope. 44, he's so dead. So, we won the battle. Hello, fairy. Like, thank you for saving me from the yucky poos. I'm totally free. Those goblins were, like, so disgusting, and their complexion were, like, so bad. We're talking serious makeovers. Okay. Like, it's not even funny. Although it kind of is. I guess I, like, owe you something in return for saving me. Let me think. A kiss? No, I'm totally not that kind of fairy. Wow, working designs. A hug? No, you're all sweaty and icky. That makes sense. Fairy dust? No, it's strong enough for a man, made for a woman. Oh. Wow. I know, I'll totally show you the secret passage to the town of Gagarl. Huzzah, that's what we want! My real question is, though, what about male fairies? Is there no male fairies? Like, do they use fairy dust that's strong enough for a man but made for a woman? Here it is. Those goblins, like, didn't even know about it. They were too busy eating rats and stuff. It's too bad you're, like, a human and I'm a fairy, you know, because you're a righteous hunk. I hope this helps you, my hero. I'm going to wait here until I'm, like, strong enough to fly home. Okay, thank you. Let's see if there's anything in this pot. Here in the pot, life root. What does that do? It's not an item. Okay. Oh, maybe I have to remove something in order to try and equip something? No. Okay. Alright. So, I guess let's talk to her one more time and see if she has anything else to say. Don't mean to offend you or anything, but you're violating my personal space. Yeah, it sounds like something she would say. I'm totally trying to stretch my rings after all this personal ordeal, and you're all grilling me for information. Take a pill. Okay. Let's head on out. So, okay, there is no bad guys there. Mountain pass. Alright, let's go down. Wonder if we'll see that fairy in the future. Wow, okay, nothing happened in here. There we go. Yay, we gained a level. So we need 69 experience points to gain up to level 8. And let's check our status. 45, so we gained 5 attack? Okay. At least I believe that's 5, if I recall correctly. Is this just a circular path? Yeah, it totally is. Just double checking. Did we make it outside? Hooray! We made it outside. Oh, and look, there's a town up there. Oh, this is around the block path. Okay. Oh, that's pretty cool. Let's head on up to this town. Looks like there's a town and a cabin beside it. All right, let's check out this town. Nobody's about. We made it. I'm proud of you, Pike. Now let's find a priest who has the power to free Laia. Only question is, where do we start? I don't know. Doesn't look like anybody's actually in the town. Is there a safe? Oh, there's somebody. Let's talk to you. A priest? Sorry, I don't know of any of them around here. Oh, great. Kitty cat, do you know where a priest is? Meow! Oh, there's another person. What do I look like? The local tourist bureau? Information is power, kiddo. But since I'm so amazingly nice, I'll only charge you 3 gold for each fact. Now, cough it up. Give him the finger. Kids to adults, eh? Okay. Let's give him gold. My first wife used to call me Shmoopy. Now she calls me Jerkface. Yeah. Okay. Thanks for taking my money. Anything in here? Nope. Oh, there's a pot out here. I wonder... Well, I was thinking you could walk around. Bringing establishment. Hoochie sips may make floppy lips or something like that. Okay. So I guess we have to find an inn for more information. Oh, can I save here? Oh, let's talk to her first. My friends say that I sound funny since I have lost my front teeth. I think I found just fine. Okay. Look, another power crystal. Let's say a prayer. Pike, let's pray that we find the priest who can bring Laia back to life. Yeah, please help Laia. Thank you, Pike. Now let's do something about this plea. Okay. Ah, there we go, a save point. That's what I was looking for. Anyway, I'm gonna end the episode here. Hopefully you enjoyed. We're gonna go from level 1 to level 7. That was actually a pretty long playthrough. But I skipped through most of the battles. I'm gonna edit through them. So, yeah. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please hit that like button. And if you're new, hit subscribe, because there's more Albert Odyssey content on the way. Anyway, we'll see you in the next episode. Ciao!